Hey you guys, Dangerous Thing here. Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another episode of Boom Beach. For all of you who have just joined my channel and you came in from either Boot Ram's channel, Boom Beach General, or if you're here checking me out from the Game Hunters channel after watching us battling it out in the Monkey Bloon Steedy Battle Arena, thank you very much for checking me out. Thank you to all of you that have hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching this video and you have not already subscribed, it would absolutely make my day, or more so evening. And I would really appreciate if you would click the red button and turn it to gray. So, but yeah, today I'm gonna show you another TF that is actually currently happening. And I'm gonna show you some of the live attacks, if there are any happening, once I pick up my lovely device. So every 24 hours, we have a few officers on the team. I just so happen to be the leader. And basically, we have been doing lots of attacks. And, you know, like I said, we do it every 24 hours. If you look at our log, you will see a lot of sour grapes and bottleneck and sour grapes and bottleneck. But in the last couple of days, 2 days to be particular, we've decided to get a little bit more aggressive. And so, you know, after a few minutes of consideration, we, and by we, I mean my designated officers, decided that we're gonna go ahead and start Tinderbox operation. Now, Tinderbox is a step above in the level of difficulty for our task force of 25 people. And so with Tinderbox, we are looking to get 690. Let me just double check. 690 OP victory points if we take down all of the bases. Now, unfortunately, yesterday we didn't fully complete the operation, so we only got 491 points out of 690 that we could have taken, which is a little bit disappointing because we could have just done bottleneck and got a total of 610, so 80 difference, but really we actually ended up in the red if you do the math. Super easy, but it doesn't matter because we are not here to compete and push for the global rank. We are here in my task force to have fun. And right after this video goes live, I am going to open my OP to 50 people. I know I've been saying it for a long time now. I was supposed to open it during Camcord stream, but then I was having internet issues and, you know, I was trying to put my green screen together, which as you can see is still not behind me because God, there are so many parts to it. Can someone please come over and help me set it up? No, just kidding, because yeah, next thing I know, you guys are actually knocking on my door, taking that back. But yesterday when we started Tinderbox, I have actually been kind of a little bit removed from the OP because if you remember, if you haven't seen the video that I posted on Sunday, I did not have a very easy weekend in my Boom Beach reality. I had a terrible, terrible day, terrible luck with Hammerman. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. I will drop a link in the description below. It was just really hard, but you know, it didn't stop me from coming in and joining in the last couple of minutes. And let me show you what it took for us to get those 461 points. 91. I once again left my glasses at work. I feel like I should get a second pair for home. So it was definitely very challenging, but that's really exciting because you don't want to just keep doing same operations. And I'm wearing a turtleneck, and because of it, it looks like I don't really have a neck, and I just, like, my body connects straight to my head, which is really weird. Yes, I am wearing a turtleneck. I do have a neck. I'm not just a head. Anyway, so it was really difficult, but as you go through the game, as you're progressing, you want to keep challenging yourself, and my task force is amazing, and they want to get, you know, they want to keep challenging themselves. And I don't know if challenge themselves is the right way to put it, because some of these guys are total monsters. They will blow me out of the water, they'll blow you out of the water. So check out some of their attacks and enjoy. All right, so let's take a look, and I will show you some of the highlights, and highlights being, you know, some of the attacks. So this was the opening attack of all Scorchers. You know, I just got a Scorcher, and in the last video, you saw how successful I was in my first ever Scorcher operation. So whenever someone goes out there and uses all Scorchers, first of all, GBE expensive. Second of all, super expensive on gold. Third of all, it takes a long time to train out and takes a lot of spots on Lanecraft. So let's take a look at this attack of Operation Destroyer. Operation Destroy also has his very own YouTube channel. If he's gonna watch this video, please drop a link in the description below because I want people to check you out. You're an amazing player. So look at what he's doing here. He's smoke screening scorchers all the way to the core. And I was pretty certain that this was gonna be an all-in-one takedown attack, but let's zoom in and let's take a look at it. Those mortars, you just watch it. I mean, they're dropping those turrets like crazy and taking down one scorcher after another. And not to mention, have you seen those rocket launchers blasting the scorchers like crazy? If Bootram was here, what would he say? He would say, fishy guacamole it is. It was blasting them hardcore. So when I was spectating that, I thought that he had it, and then, you know, obviously just the splash damage and the health of the core and the health of the nearby defense buildings is just astonishing. So he did an old scorcher attack, which in my book, even if not a win, an A-okay attack. And I guess A-okay would be that. Derp. Trying to come up with a name with my fingers and not quite working out for me. But then let me show you a few other attacks. Oh, check that out, the Game Hunter. One and only the Game Hunter doing his favorite combo of hookahs, and I'm not gonna go through all of the attacks. And if you are watching this video, if you are in my task force and I did not show you attack, please don't get upset. It's not because I didn't think it wasn't important or because it wasn't amazing. I'm just doing this totally randomly. But I did want to show the Destroyer because, you know, I'm fascinated with Scorchers. So here is the Game Hunter rolling in his hookah combo, and, you know, once the heavies go down, so do the hookahs, or the zookas. they are only as strong as they are whenever they are protected by the heavies. So, unfortunately, he only got 3 VPs on this one, but nice try, keep it coming. Okay, let's take a look at somebody else. We got Nina, we got Death Warrior, Red, okay, Ramo, EC, Jabik. Okay, so Joe Beef is one of my newer players. Thank you for joining our TF. We're very happy and proud to have you. And he also decided that he's gonna go ahead and show it off a little bit and use the infamous Torture Scorcher Skank combination, whatever. You know, whatever strikes your fancy. So he decides to just, you know, keep it rolling pretty slowly and starts from the left flank, and then he decides to flare away from the mini cores because, you know, you only got 3 minutes and tanks are a little bit slow, so you have to budget your time properly. I've done that mistake before where I've used tanks and I was like, oh, I definitely got this base down, and then I run out of time, and, you know, that's just a waste of money and waste of an attack, especially in task force where you have a limited number of attacks allocated to the operation. So he basically takes out some of the mini cores on the back of the power core, and then he heals up his tanks, puts them all in one spot, and zooms them in on the zoom, zoom, zoom power core. And just like that, the power core goes down. And actually, I've noticed the other day when I was watching one of the replays, look at these cool vents in the back. I mean, I have to give it to Supercell. Very little details that may not really matter at first, but make a really big difference, because as you play through the game and you have been playing it for a while, you know, details like that is what keeps you entertained. And actually, these ones here are spinning as well, so it's kind of awesome. And look at all these nasty, nasty drips of water dripping into the ocean. Whenever I see that, it always makes me really sad because I start thinking of environmental issues, but I'm not gonna go into that. Maybe I'll do a vlog on that a little bit later. I'm a crazy eco-friendly person and I recycle and compost and bike to work. If you're biking to work, don't forget to wear your helmet. Here is my propaganda for the day. Wear your helmet, recycle and compost. Okay, now let's take a look at Karkars. And he is doing an all ladies attack. He's one heck of a player when it comes to using Zookas, but look at that right there. Didn't even have to deploy them, but if you haven't seen it, I'm gonna do it again. Oh heck, right here. He basically drops his girls right over here. And then he drops, why did I do that? I could have just pressed play again. And then he drops the critters on the shore right as he already takes down the core. So let's zoom in right here on the shore. Core goes down and he drops critters, which is kind of funny because for a second I thought, are they like making letters or something? But no, they didn't. So that was that, and I'm gonna go ahead and show you Hisin, who is one of my most dedicated members of the team. He has been the longest standing officer in my task force, and Hisin did an all warrior rush, and you know, we've been chatting about it after the attack. He basically goes all the way from the other side of the base and tries to use his smoke screen strategically, and you know, gets his warriors kind of discombobulated a little bit, so it doesn't end up being a very successful OP. A warrior rush is one of the most challenging operations and one of the most challenging combos for me personally. I know that people that manage to perfect warrior rush are very successful in Boom Beach. When Boot Ramp was visiting with his girlfriend, you know, he let me play with his account and let me sort of work out the semantics and the mechanics of the warrior rush, and I actually got a few of them down. I was pretty proud of myself, but I have to say that in task force operations, it is so difficult to get the power core down with all warriors. And maybe it's because of my level, maybe it's because of the level of my TF, but I feel like when the power core has, you know, however much health, let's take a look at one of the current operations and see what the power core health is of one of the bases that hasn't been attacked. Actually, all of them seems like have been attacked, but let's look at this one here. This isn't even a high difficulty base, but it has gotten 489,964 health points. It is very difficult to take it down when you have all the defense buildings left standing around of the power core and you have limited amount of GBE, and as you keep shocking those defenses, you know, the GBE value of the shock goes up every single time you throw it. So I don't know, you know, if eventually I will figure it out and I'll perfect it, but to me it seems that warrior rush may be one of the most difficult combos for TF to take down the power core entirely in one and done attack. I know that you can take it down, you know, once certain things have been cleared up, once certain defenses have been taken out, and so you're not spending too much GB on shocking the defenses, but now I'm just rambling. If you guys are in a task force that isn't mine and you have had success taking down power core with all warriors on the first attack without, you know, damaging the core from the beginning at all, let me know. And if you have a link to that video, I would love to watch it. I find it amazingly entertaining and of course educational. You can always learn from watching people play that are better than you are. So that is that for the last tinderbox attack that we did. The one that we started a few minutes ago is still going on, and we've actually already had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, why am I doing counts? I can just look at how many people, how many attacks are remaining. We have 17 attacks remaining, which means that 8 people have already attacked. And from those 8 people, we have taken down one of the bases. OP here is once again amazing. I actually spectated this one live before I started recording. All Zuka attack, one and done attack on this base. Let's watch him and let's watch him do what he's doing best. He loves doing all Zukas. If you haven't seen his videos where he takes down Gearheart with all Zukas, amazing. What are you doing? Go and check it out right after you finish this video. So he is being pretty sneaky about keeping his Zukas outside of the radius of the splash damage of those defense buildings. He drops critters to distract the sniper tower and of course boom cannons or cannons, which now they're becoming in the range. So he smokescreens Zukas right up to the power core. He flames them on the power core, throws critters, and just like that. I mean, tell me that this was not amazing. It was absolutely beautiful. I think he lost a few Zukas. Let's take a look. So he deployed with 96 and he lost 30. You know, but it still is a fantastic attack. So the operation task force number 2 is now in the swing, and we have one base left standing, which I probably could take down with just GVE. And actually I did that again on the previous tinderbox. I'm pretty sure I took this down with, I thought it was gonna be a GBE takedown only, but after throwing a few barrages at it, I realized that it is not going down that easy. So luckily I had Huga combo here, and I decided to reflare them after I did the first flare, and I flare them again. So I'm spending a lot of GBE on flare right now. Well, not a lot. It's not the most expensive of all of the GBE energy spenders, whatever, I don't know what I'm saying, but it went down pretty easy. I lost a few, I'm pretty sure I lost a few heavies because Zookas were still outside of the range. Well, actually, maybe I lost a few Zookas. Let's take a look. Yeah, no, I didn't lose any Zookas. Why can't I see? Okay, let's take a look. I lost no Zookas, but I lost 6 heavies. So that is going to be it from you guys. I will check in with you later and tell you how the second task force of Tinderbox went for us. Unfortunately, there are no players live right now attacking. But if you haven't seen the video of Boom Beach General and I, we were talking about some of the new updates and things that we would like to see. Obviously, you know, this isn't Supercell endorsed, and we were just throwing ideas at each other, as he would say, tossing some ideas. And one of the things that I've mentioned was creating a function of sending a message to each individual task force member, which would be really awesome. So, you know, we're currently just discussing in our chat all things task force and whatnot. So thank you very much for checking in for this video. Once again, if you have not already subscribed, please do so. It'll make my day, my week, my month, and maybe my year. You just never know. And I will catch you guys next time. Until then, Dangerous Thing is out.